Welcome back. Our elderly senior population is growing. 65 and over is growing in 2013, and there were 44.5 million seniors in the United States. In 2060, it is estimated that there will be approximately 98 million wow. elderly people in the United States.
Mm-hmm. 2060, that seems like forever. MCO is here from Edgewood Senior Living to talk about one of the areas concerning the elderly population, and those are the ones living in rural areas. Mm-hmm. So welcome to the show. You do hear a lot about, if you're elderly in a very rural area, like healthcare right. issues, things like that, mm-hmm. what kind of support is out there for them?
Well, you know, we do find that they're in rural areas and they're kind of separated from help or other people. And so it's really important to have options out there. And so we do in North Dakota and all of our seven states that Edgewood is a part of, we have our communities are in larger cities, but then they're also in the rural communities as well to help support those people. So around this area here, we have Tamarack, which is in Stephen, Minnesota, which is really a great option for people.
Mm-hmm. So what do you mean, Tamarack? And I guess yep. I'm not following. So you've sure. got Edgewood's in like major, yep. more urban
it's the
areas.
Same North then. Dakota. We have Bismarck, Minot, Mandan, Grand Forks. But then we also have in smaller communities as well, we have a place in Stephen, Minnesota, which is called Tamarack. And so we have in our larger cities, but then we also have in our smaller communities too, we have some Edgewood's to choose from as well.
So what are the benefits of living in Edgewood or Tamarack?
Mm-hmm. What I love to see, especially going to Tamarack, it reminds me of going to grandma's. It mm-hmm. smells like grandma's baked bread, and there's community, there's involvement, there's people that are there to help with the needs that they have. Because sometimes what happens is when we live on our own in rural communities, we don't have access to healthcare right on the spot. And so that's something that's so important at Edgewood for us is to have nurses on site, but we also have therapy as well, so people won't have to go out, especially in our harsh winter months, to go out and seek help. It's there for them right away.
Mm. So there are other locations as well in North Dakota that you have, or let's say I'm in a very rural spot. Mm-hmm. Do there are people that come out and help me, or how does that work?
Well, with Edgewood, people live at Edgewood in our communities. So we have people that come to us to live. But in our area right now, the Tamarack in Stephen is our rural location, but we do have several throughout the state that are in our major cities.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So how can people get a hold of you if I'm looking for either moving a loved one there or I'm a senior and want to, see if mm-hmm. this would mm-hmm. be a good fit for me?
Right. They can contact edgewoodseniorliving.com or they can come to any of our locations and visit with us there. And it's so important. You think about all the things that are there for us, but a lot of it is camaraderie, having people to connect with and be with. And that's so important. And having the resources there that can help people to help them make the decisions for them. So are you with them?
Go ahead.
So are you guys open to giving like tours and letting people just check it out?
Absolutely. Coming in and seeing for yourself what we have and what we have to offer and the people that are there is the best thing for you to do. Mm-hmm. So, yes.
Can you come like have a meal and everything?
Oh,
and
absolutely.
Okay, good.
Spend a day.
Yes,
like a
resort.
We have happy hour at our
happy
locations
hour?
Wow.
as well. Yep. So it's a lot of fun. There's lots there. And so we have independent living, assisted living, and we also have mm-hmm. memory cares. So depending on what your needs are and what you feel best with, that's where we help you and have a personalized assessment for people.
Do you bring in DJs that play Mikos too?
Yeah, there we go.
Is that what it
is? You know what, Chris, if you want to come, we'll do that for you.
Oh my gosh. So. I don't think, I mean, if you did, that would actually be kind
yeah.
of
But no, we do have live music that comes as well.
You do? So,
absolutely, absolutely. What we do is we find out what our residents' needs are and what they want to have there, and then we bring those things to them.
But like you said, you have assisted living too, and uh-huh. but you also yes. have that more free living where...
Yes, independent living is where people can come and go. Anyone can come and go as they want. But with that, they do everything themselves, but then they can choose to have meals with us as well if they'd like. But then assisted living is where we have help with medications. We have help bringing people to the dining rooms if they need help with that. There's a lot of things. Everyone's care is individualized there. So,
oh, wow.
Yes.
Great. So, anything else you want to add?
Well, I just think it's so important to take a look at things, especially have conversations with your families before the time arises so that there's real communication there, but then there's not making those hard decisions when it's actually time. You're seeing what needs to be done, and coming for a tour, like you mentioned, is just wonderful.
Thank you very much.
Yes, thank you
so much for being here.
All right, stick around. We got a lot more coming up right here on North Dakota Today.